फ्रॉम द स्टार्टिंग. ओके, रिकॉर्डिंग से पहले क्या सुना था हम लोगों ने?
So we started with the metal.
We started with the metal. Okay. These are the 9 planets. This is the metals that they indicate. Sun indicates copper, moon indicates gem, Mars indicates gold, Mercury indicates alloy. And it also indicates Mercury, that is known as Parat. Jupiter indicates silver, Venus indicates pearl, Saturn indicates iron, Rahu indicates Panchadhatu, Ketu indicates Ashtadhatu. Though for all the Saturn, Rahu, Ketu, you can take that they indicate stone. Idols made up of stone. Yantras made up of stone is not there. So Yantras made up of Panchadhatu, Ashtadhatu, or Yantra made up of iron. Right? So you can either use Yantras made up of these metals, or you can use idols made up of this metal also. Right? Coming to home, Sun indicates temple, Moon indicates water bodies, Mars indicates weapons, Mercury indicates study area and park, Jupiter indicates money. Study area where the children study, and park is where children play. So children also play in home, they also go outside home to play, the playing area. Jupiter indicates the area where you keep your money, keep your cash box. Venus indicates bedroom, Saturn indicates dustbin, Rahu indicates toilet. What Ketu indicates, I don't know. Sun is a fire element, Moon is a water element, Mars is a fire element, Mercury is of earth element, Jupiter is of Akasha element. Venus is of water element again, Saturn is air element, Rahu is also air element, and Ketu is fire element. Fire element is represented by fire itself. Fire element is fire or light. That light can be of different colors depending on the sign and the navamsha of sun. Water indicates water body, a fountain or something like that. Earth is equal to wood. Or the quality of earth is to give fragrance, right? Akash is the open space, empty space. And air is once again things which give fragrance, or you know, air producing things, air conditioners, etc. These are indicated by these elements, right? Now gods, God I will write it that. God, I have to tell. I will repeat it. Sun in Dashavatar, Sun indicates Ram, Moon indicates Krishna, Mars indicates Narasimha. Mercury though indicates Gautam Buddha, but I take Mercury to indicate the spiritual gurus like Ramana Maharshi, Ramakrishna Paramahansa, etc. That is indicated by Mercury. Jupiter indicates Vaman, Venus indicates Parasuram, Saturn indicates Kurma Avatar from Samudra Mantra. Rahu indicates Varaha and Ketu indicates Matasya. Generally, Sun from 0 degree to 20 degree of a dual sign indicates Vishnu. And from 20 degree to 30 degree of a dual sign, and in fixed sign and movable signs, indicate Shiva. Moon of bright fortnight indicate motherly form of goddess such as Parvati, etc. And in dark fortnight indicates the fierce form of goddess such as Kali, Chamunda, etc. Mars in a male sign indicates male protective god, Bhairava, Subramanya, Kartikeya, etc. Hanuman. And Mars in a female sign indicates a female aggressive devi such as Kali, Tara, Chamunda, Chandi, Rakhtadantika, etc. Mercury in a dual sign indicates Krishna. Movable sign indicates Rama, and fixed sign indicates Vishnu. Jupiter indicates the deity signified by the lord of the sign. In his own sign Sagittarius, it indicates Shiva, and in his female sign Pisces, it indicates Vishnu. Venus in Leo, Cancer, Pisces and Sagittarius indicates Annapurna. Venus in Gemini, Virgo, Libra and Taurus indicates Lakshmi. And Venus in Capricorn, Aquarius, Scorpio and Aries indicates Kul Devi or Kul Devata. Right? If you don't know your Kul Devi or Kul Devata, for a Kshatriya they can worship Ram. For a Brahman they can worship Vaman. Right? For a businessman they can worship Lakshmi. Saturn generally indicates Vishnu. So for Saturn I will say male sign Vishnu, female sign Narayana. Rahu indicates Saraswati in a female sign, Durga in a male sign, Ketu indicates Ganesha. You can have images of these deities, yantras of these deities, etc. In this nakshatra vastu stuff that I am just going to teach about. Okay. Now other things indicated by these. The direction ruled by sun is east. Moon is northwest. Mars is south. Jupiter is northeast. Mercury is north. Venus is southeast. Saturn is west. Rahu is southwest. Ketu indicates the upwards direction, sky. Like fan, right? There are other things indicated by these planets also that you can use as per your own intelligence, right? Like sun is the karaka for authority, so it will indicate things that show your authority, awards and prizes, etc. Right? Moon also indicates, you know, imagination, cinema. Things which give you comfort, solace, etc. Right? That is sofa or, you know, picture of a loved one. TV, home theater, etc. Though home theater will more come into the sound section of Saturn, because Saturn rules over the air element. Mars is about weapons, fire, you know, fighting abilities. Mercury is about books, learning and mental things, you know. So that is books, learning, amusement things, other things. That is ruled by Mercury. Mercury indicating the earth element also indicates the section where you can have the flower pot, etc. Earth element you have in the flower pot. As I told you earlier, earth element also is also indicated by wood. Jupiter indicates things related to worship, rosary, etc. Jupiter is also the karaka for turmeric, haldi. Right. Venus indicates things related to enjoyments, things related to sexuality, luxury, comfort, movie watching, photography, cinema, etc. Right. Saturn indicates things made up of iron, heavy things made up of engineering or things which you use for your work. Because Saturn is a servant. So when you become a servant, which tools you use? Saturn will also indicate things made up of leather. So leather shoes, etc. Rahu is more related to the excretion things. You know, things you want to excrete, things you want to throw. Or outcome of, you know, like the leftover stuff for Rahu. So these are the multiple things indicated by the planets. Though I have already told you in depth about how to use this table. But this particular section I have to cut and put it on YouTube. So just, you know, remember what I told earlier and just listen to what I'm saying now. So you see a planet and you make sure that you have to activate it. See, Astro Vastu is more about activation and not about remedy. It's about activation. You remember it. How to remedy is what we have talked before. How to remedy a planet, we have learned before. Astro Vastu is more about activation. So suppose we look at a horoscope of this person. I see that there is an exalted Jupiter in the 10th house. And suppose this person is wanting to have a good professional life. Who is not wanting? Everyone is wanting. So this person wants a good professional life. So I see this Jupiter. Now this Jupiter is the lord of the 3rd house and the 6th house in the 10th house. Right? So first of all, the negative result of the 3rd house and 6th house have to be pacified. Right? 6th house indicates service. 3rd house indicates courage. So first of all, he have to be courageous. And have to do a few things related to courage. Because 6th house indicates service, he should do some service to Jupiter temple. Like, you know, that is the temple of a guru or the deity indicated by Jupiter, right? Vaman temple. Or here Jupiter is in the sign of Cancer, so Devi temple, he should do worship there. And he should also help and support some woman because this Jupiter is the lord of the 3rd house. This needs to be done for the pacification of the ill results of Jupiter. Though how to really pacify it, I have told you in the starting of the class, right? So that don't forget. Now this Jupiter is in Pushya Nakshatra 3rd Pada. The Pushya Nakshatra indicates east. Okay. So in the east direction of his home, in the east direction of his home, he should have things signified by Jupiter. What is the thing signified by Jupiter that he can keep in the east direction of his home? East direction indicates power. It is ruled by Sun. I want to activate Jupiter. What is common between Sun and Jupiter? It should also be related to power. There is one common factor between every planet that you have to find. The crux of this nakshatra vastu falls there in finding the common. See, the crux of complete astrology falls in finding the common. So what is common between Sun and Jupiter? Sun indicate temple, Jupiter indicate God. This is common. So temple in the east direction, and there have to be a prime God in the temple. Basically, if you go by the Panchayatan worship, there is a prime God in the temple and other are the subsidiary gods. Prime God is the Ishta Devata. Basically, Ishta Devata is the prime God. Now you can have any Ishta Devata. But because this direction east is power, that form of East Devata which is indicating power should be the major installation in the temple. Major installation is the most costly murti, most biggest murti, whatever you take. You generally have one murti made up of gold in your house, or every murti made up of gold, then so you are very rich. And or you can say, because Sun indicates copper, you can take the copper murti. And it can be the biggest of all the gods. That is the East Devata. So first of all, we have to find the East Devata of this person. If he have an East Devata, that is okay. We tell, okay, make this image of East Devata. Like suppose his East Devata is Ram. What is the powerful form of Ram? When Ram is sitting on his throne with Sita and with everyone, with, you know, with Hanuman serving him, that is the Ram at the most powerful position. If it was south, south is protection. Right? If it was north, it is the planet blessing. Abhay Mudra, Varada Mudra. You know the difference between Abhay Mudra and Varada Mudra. Abhay Mudra is handled like this, Varada Mudra is handled like this, of the deity. Right? The imagery iconography. And the west direction is the god in interaction with someone else. Showing power, interacting, resting, sleeping, protecting, granting boons. Then there are, it is for cardinal directions also that we will go in the next class, leave it for today.
Okay.
So an image made up of copper ruled by sun, or an image made up of silver signified by Jupiter of the Ishta Devata in a position where he is showing his power should be placed in a temple made up of wood, because sun indicates wood. Or sorry, we have to remedy Jupiter. Right? Should be placed in, you can take a temple, generally it is only a wood temple, should be placed in the east direction for the pacification of Jupiter. And because Jupiter indicates either element, Akash Tattva, there have to be a window behind the temple. That area have to be well lit. And the person have to light some fragrance related thing, you know, that flows through the Akash, right? Some fragrance related thing like dhoop, etc. There every day as a remedy for this particular Jupiter.